Easy Gel today. We have a lot of questions on Easy Gel, what it is, how it works, what we're going to do. Jamie, NP Jamie, superstar of my world, is going to, I'm going to build her up as much as possible because she already hurt me. She already took my blood.
Sorry, God.
Five tubes they took from me, and I'm going skiing tomorrow. I'm not going to have enough hemoglobin at the elevation I'm going to be at.
Did
you calculate that?
I did not.
At 12,000 feet, if I'm going to have oxygen to my brain?
I did not.
They're going to say I never have oxygen in my brain. So we're going to talk about exactly what we're going to do. The first thing is we took five tubes of blood. As you have questions, just keep asking.
Did you pass out this time?
I never passed out last time, but I make fun about it because if I say I'm going to, then I won't. Because I'm never successful with things, so if I say the opposite of what's going to happen. So I didn't. Five tubes. Did I pass out,
Jamie? A lot of people from London are saying hi, by the way.
London, England or London, Ontario? Big difference.
UK.
Okay. London Knights hockey.
And people say hi to you, Jamie. They're like, you did my PRF. Oh, you're awesome.
Nice.
So there we go.
Do you want all three PRFs, Ben?
Yes.
Okay, cool.
So we did five tubes. One of the things I believe, Jamie and I have been doing PRF since 2014 or so, and the gel now for a few years. I believe we're underdosing people. So typically, if we're doing a full face, I'm getting at least four total tubes, which is giving us 10 cc's yield. So that's what we're going to do today. We're going to see if there are places when she does my consult that I can get 10 cc's. But it's all natural. So what I believe we're doing with this, of course we get skin glow. Of course we get skin tightening. But I think we're making the fat pads better. That seems to be what we're doing.
Yeah.
I saw an under eye back yesterday and it was a gentleman and we did just liquid PRF as part of my plasma skull. Beautiful.
And I feel like the results are much longer out too. Like they're initial, but they last a lot longer
Yeah. And then you just need a touch up. So we do probably the most with this procedure is under eyes will be our number one, Jamie.
Yeah, 100%.
And under eyes are the toughest thing people do in practice. Yeah. What we're doing here, she's drawing up the albumin. That is the fast spin. Now I got full of chylomicrons in there.
Yeah, we had a lot of good stuff.
I've been eating and drinking. I've been on the road in Monaco. I've been in France. Been in Germany.
You have some people from Australia, Florida, Ontario, London.
I gotta go to Australia. I'm scared to death of your guys' ocean. I want to go windsurfing and kite surfing, but I'm scared of the tentacles of those jellyfish, the sharks a little bit. What you got? Like stuff in that ocean that doesn't exist anywhere else in the world. So I'm scared to death, but I'm coming to Australia. I love it. I'm gonna have a good time. But
New York says hi.
Of course, dude, we got New York in the house. It's like almost time to go to the club. You better get ready. We better hurry up. New York, 3 hours in the difference. So we're drying up the albumin. Now, there's not a lot of cells in here, okay? So this is albumin. We're going to heat it so that the proteins unfold, and that's going to give us our volume. And I do run a little high cholesterol, and you can kind of see. It's a little, would you say? I'm running a little...
I do run.
They're trying to get me on those statin drugs, and I don't take any of that stuff. I don't take drugs or anything.
You're eating too much butter?
I love butter. And I was just in France. I eat a baguette and butter every day, a stick of butter and baguette. So
you're having everyone come on. We have people from Hong Kong, Florida.
Nice.
Please tell us where you're from. Bangkok. This is great.
We're doing
Hamilton,
Bangkok,
Ontario.
This year in November.
Texas.
We'll be in Texas
Salt Lake.
In June and July. And Vegas in July. So,
Turcos and Caicos, that's great.
Oh, I gotta go there, kite surfing. You Turks and Caicos has the best.
Germany, got a Germany here.
So let me, want to hear any science? Does anyone want to hear what I have to say for science?
Yes.
So, what the proteins will unfold, that gets your gel. Now, she's now, I believe, Jamie, you're at the point of slow spin.
Yes.
Okay, so she's slow spinning three tubes right now. So we're going to get liquid PRF for your female patients. You can add some liquid PRF for the brow. I already got a lot of comments about my brows being crazy, out of control. What's wrong with you, doc? Are you not grooming? So I'm not going to get plasma brow today because they're already too big, apparently. I got it. So, but you can grab that extra tube to do some brow. You can also obviously do head hair, which of course I've had done, as you see. I get a cut every 2 or 3 weeks. I don't know what the hell's going on now, but it's growing up.
Quick question. As you age, does that efficacy or...
Efficacy decrease? Yeah. This is the best question. We treat, and you look at, if you go to plasmafil.com, you'll see patients of all ages. No, it works great. I think it's your health. It's what you're eating real food, exercise, activity, if you have a healthy person, and just use this as your gauge. If they were to cut themselves and their skin heals, that means their growth factors are working. That means their platelets are aggregating. That means they have exosomes. Mm-hmm. And we never talk about exosomes in PRF, but PRP exos, so it's studied in PRP. I'm still researching the data on exosomes, but we'll have a count for you soon. All exosomes are messengers that tell the body what to do. They create proteins. So in this case, we want exosomes that renew skin. So yes, when you get older, you still have all of those things. Growth factors, when they harvest them, 4 growth factors, 4 exosomes that you buy exogenously in the bottle. Yes, they usually take them from 21-year-olds, but yours work just fine.
Got a couple of shout outs from Pakistan, Chicago, Mexico. So
wonderful.
They're all wondering what you're drinking. Is there any alcohol in there? It is Friday.
No, I was on the road for 3 weeks straight, living in planes and hotels and everything. And of course you go out at night and you have the odd cocktail. So when I come home, I drink zero. So I won't have a sip of anything for probably 6 or 7 weeks now. And I'll get the body back, I'll get healthy. You can't live that life being on the road like that. So no, this is, what is it, Haley? Carrot juice?
Carrot and pineapple.
Carrot and pineapple. They feed me this. I had a salad today at lunch.
A question from Turks and Caicos. Yes. Can you combine smooth threads with easy gel?
So here's the thing. Like, if you see my face, it's red. Yesterday, I had fractionated RF. I had RF microneedling. Jamie had the day off. Otherwise, I would have had my plasma pill yesterday. And I love that you weren't here because, you know, I get you today and it's exciting to have you here as always. But if she had been here, she would have done that and then take the PRF and put it over my face, right?
Yes.
So we do all of it in one day. And yes, you can take, smooth threads and PRF works great. You can even take it and you take the thread where you engage it, where you put the thread in, kind of the hub, and you can inject your PRF through the smooth thread. So that's a cool little trick you can do. So combine as much as you can. You want to heat first. You don't want to heat your PRF. Like, in other words, don't do RF microneedling after. You want to do all those procedures first. But the benefit is she can take the PRF and put it on, mm-hmm. quote unquote, the wounds. Yes.
Can you do PRF over old filler in the cheeks?
It's wonderful. Mm-hmm. So what we do, and I'm talking all the time, but Jamie, feel free to pipe in here, but what I do is I look at the filler. If the filler looks good but they need a little tune-up, mm-hmm. I just layer it on top. It's great. If the filler looks bad to begin with, why not dissolve it?
Yes.
Because if you're losing face fat or you think you're going to lose your own collagen or hyaluronic acid from dissolver, like hyaluronidase, this is the antidote to that. If you think you've lost face fat from Ulthera or RF treatments or IPLs, this is the antidote to that. I really, like, what we're seeing mm-hmm. is skin and fat.
Yeah.
I mean, you see hundreds of people back. We've done thousands.
And I would definitely say that's very common for the lip also. When people have lip filler, like, do they like it? Do they not like it? And then you can always layer that on top of it. Some people just want pink or redness to the color of the lip, especially PRF for sure. But I always ensure that they like the look of the filler first before we go in there and kind of agitate anything or get things rebuilding with their own lip plasma.
I think you dissolve more stuff than I do. Like, it seems mm-hmm. like you're using dissolve a lot more.
Yeah.
Her clientele mm-hmm. wants to start over a little bit more.
Particularly in the under eye as well.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. How do we find the setting for the first spin and slow pin? Is there like an instruction manual?
Yeah, it all comes, if you see the kit box over there, everything comes together and everything you need to do, including the blood draw, including the connectors, including the color-coded syringes, including the syringes that are heat resistant, because you don't want plasticizers in your stuff. It all comes in one kit. So you grab the kit, you open it up, and you're done. Each kit's gonna produce 5 mLs. We use 2 kits today, we'll have 10 mLs. I'm not worried about being overdone because it's just rejuvenating the original fat I have. However, you do wanna put it in the areas that you wanna accentuate, but it's not like a filler. You have a little bit of leeway because I'm rejuvenating what I have.
And when you decide to use Easy Gel versus plain PRF for under eye?
That's a great question. If you want a little more volume, like for me, what I believe, I leave it up to, I mean, I don't try not to look at myself and figure out what I need, but I get an idea, but I'll say to Jamie, hey, I feel like I need a little bit of volume. We're going with the gel. Mm-hmm. I don't have a lot of lines that I believe up that go up to my lower lid. You know, this is something that people have to tell you because she sees me dynamic, smiling, crying, laughing. But if she believes there's lines up in my lid, she'll want to do a liquid to get the lid.
Yeah, and I find that true when I want to like blanket an area. I like to start off with PRF because it's not just one line usually. It's like the whole area. So I like to blanket the area, get that rolling, and then their next session, come back in and thread a little bit of Easy Gel on that specific line or that specific hollow that they're seeing.
Not to talk about this before you get injection, but do you ever worry about occlusion with Easy PRF?
It's great to talk about. Mm-hmm. I worry about occlusion with everything. So as you know, there's cases of people putting all kinds of things, even like an injection of a steroid that we use in dermatology in the ear, and people go blind. So you have to always worry about it. We use cannulas. The risk I took 2 weeks ago skiing off a helicopter, I mean, that's a million times worse. That helicopter couldn't even climb up. We're at, I don't know how many, 15,000, 20,000 feet. That's way riskier. So you stratify your risk, right? So what is the risk of it? It's one in maybe, for one, there has, with PRF gel, and I know you're gonna pull up some esoteric papers from clinics that are in backyards and all these places, but there's never been an occlusion from it. I've looked at the cases in it and looked at where they came from. Now, PRP is gonna say there's some cases, there's a couple of bona fide cases, but a lot of them, look where they came. Often they were mixed with hyaluronic acid fillers and they were backyard clinics. Mm-hmm. Not that it can't happen, so I always believe it could happen. That's how I operate.
And can you define for all of us what PRF and PRP is?
Sure. How are you doing on spins?
Good, I got 30 more seconds of heating and then 2 of cooling. And
okay, great, so she's going. So PRP, to me, is like injecting water in the face. It's a fast spin. All the cells go to the bottom of the tube and you get serum at the top, which is what she's heating. Mm-hmm. With PRF, we're slow spinning. Exosomes, to take an example, are 100 nanometers. Growth factors are small. So we want to spin it slow so that only the red blood cells go to the bottom and some of the white cells. At the top of the tube where she took all the goodness, I want white cells, I want growth factors, I want exosomes.
So this is about the 10-minute mark. A little liquid still, so I might heat it for just a smidge longer, but it starts to get solidified where you won't see any of those kind of small bubbles in there.
I tend to find 11 minutes mm-hmm. is what I end up being at, right? We're at 73 degrees.
Mm-hmm, correct.
And you can go up to 75. Mm-hmm. I've heated it to 25, 45, 50 minutes to see what happens to it and looked at that, but in general, that's way too much, obviously. Yeah. So 11, 12, 13, you're fine. And so it's a slow spin. Understand, she needs to get growth factors, stem cells, and exosomes in that for me to get a great result. So when you spin it, the angle of the spinner, the speed of the spinner, and the size and type of tube are all very particular to your spin. So use a studied system. In this case, we use Easy Gel, Easy PRF, CosmoFrance.net if you want to look up, or go to my websites and you'll see it. But yes, so PRP also is heparin and sodium citrate, which is why you find it stings. And you never put blood thinner on a cut.
Yep.
Okay, it stops the wound healing process. Why would you put it in your PRP? For convenience. We don't need convenience, we got brains. And that's what PRF and PRF gel is, using your brain to actually make something. So it's not set it and forget it. You actually have to think.
Perfect. And how many treatments do you usually say to a patient they need, or is that dependent on the patient?
So when Jamie looked at me and she saw 3 weeks that I just had, And I don't smoke cigarettes or anything, but I'll tell you, you go to Vegas, you're inhaling all that stuff. I can't stand it.
And this is at 11 minutes.
Perfect. And how's it look to you? It
looks pretty great.
Good. Yeah. That's your heated gel. So when you have to figure, if my testosterone is falling through the floor for some reason, like for a female when they lose estrogen, you're going to need more treatments. If I'm getting photo damage, I'm going to need more treatments. I maintain some things. I just had treatment yesterday. My last treatment was a year ago, and I don't feel like, I'm not desperate to get this done, but it's been a year. Am I desperate to get it done, Jamie? You're my provider.
No, you look great.
I should be asking the pro, not Haley. You want to grab this?
Can you use this with Botox and other treatments too?
Yes. Let me give you a caveat on that I found. If you're treating the lateral corrugator with Botox, Dysport is what we use most of, then be mindful if you're doing plasma brow. You can go to plasmabrow.com because it will diffuse it a little bit. So I think the risk of having a brow droop, not the lid droop, but the brow droop is a little higher. So that's the only one. I think you do get more spread of effect.
Yeah.
I don't know, what do you see?
No, I agree with that. I usually wait for like a brow lift after the brow gel just to make sure that I'm not dropping the brow, because as we know, the brows frame the face and it's a big part of makeup nowadays and people's appearance. So I just play the safer route and I'll do two separate appointments for that. And it's a chance for me to see them back and kind of see how they're doing healing wise. And if they have any questions, I'm here.
Do you have an issue with the Easy PRF clogging the cannula?
Great question.
And how do you ensure a smooth injection?
You're going to see it today, but if it starts to clog, sometimes you need a new cannula, it's okay, whatever. If you heat it for too long, maybe, but if you start to get that, mix it back and forth again.
A lot,
right? Like I'm a mixer like 20 times, like 1, 2, 3, are you about 20?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We're about 20 times. It means it's not smooth enough or you've heated too long. Mm-hmm. But could it happen? Yeah. Those are the hurdles that injectors get over that make them great. Mm-hmm. If she's frustrated and she stops using it, great. Let everyone else stop using it. We're doing it. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like that's the way it was with Sculptor back in the day. People would fail mm-hmm. because it's not instant. But if you overcome these hard hurdles,
yeah.
it makes you into puts you into greatness. So yes, it
could
clog some.
Couple
Don't
more.
Lose your mind.
Great questions here. One, we need an extra hockey player tomorrow in Whitefish, short flight.
I'm in. Now.
I thought you were skiing.
No, I'm good. I can do both. I'm ready to go. This horse is ready to leave the gate. I've been cooped up in hotels forever.
The Here's next the, one is, should you avoid
cats? I want to go back to hockey. That's more fun for
okay,
me.
Okay.
No, but I didn't ski for 4 years before that heli trip, so I'm talking a big game in the bar the night before, but that all worked out. But so if you want me to play hockey, that's a problem, because I haven't played now since like the summer, because I'm traveling, so I can't guarantee anything. But anyway, go ahead. But I would love to play.
And Doc, just so you know, I'm getting ready to mix it, but since you got a pretty good amount of PRF, I'm going to transfer it into a small one so you have more mixing room.
Great.
And that can be something that makes your risk of clogging a lot less in your cannula is that you mix it enough and you have enough air in the other side so you can push it back and forth enough.
And keep in mind, you don't have to make such a robust gel. Mm-hmm. If she looks at my under, she's like, well, he doesn't need that much G prime or force to lift it forward because she did such a great job a year ago, then she can make it a little smoother and go to a 1-to-1 mixture.
Correct.
So you can play with concentrations.
I knew you guys were going to talk about this, but what depth of the Easy PRF gel for the under eyes?
So we do a 2-depth technique when we want to do skin and volume. Understand there's good papers that show bone growth with platelet-rich fiber. So we do put, and of course the bone ages the eye, it rotates, it kind of melts if you think of face. So we put a layer deep below the orbicularis oculi muscle, and then if we want, we can put a liquid layer on top of the muscle. So 2-layer technique.
And then we're just mixing it here.
That's the coolest part in the world right there.
It's the funnest too.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
You gotta make sure your lure connector is on so you don't lose all your stuff for sure to come apart, but you wanna mix it.
Can you use the PRF gel if you're on blood thinners?
You know, I make sure they have most people you're talking about Coumadin, and I make sure, check to make sure there's an INR between 2 and 3, and we do it. Because understand, you got exosomes, you got tons of goodness in your blood, and we're just harvesting that. Think of PRP, there's heparin in there, in the tube.
Yeah.
So if you think the Coumadin that they're taking or a bit of low molecular weight heparin is going to be a problem. PRP's got it in the tube. So
we have someone requesting you to come to Qatar. When's your next trip?
Well, I finish here today, whenever we're done. And then Sunday, I'll figure out where I'm flying to. So Sunday to Monday, but I don't know where I'm going yet. So we'll find out. Everything's last minute for me now. But Qatar, great. Love to come over there.
Why is PRP more common than PRF? Like, why?
It's because that's the narrative out there. It's also what's been used in joints and shoulders. It's also been used for studies. But if you look at the dental world, I would say PRF is more common. And it's finicky for aesthetics. So there's no blood thinner in there. So in aesthetics, it would clot, clot, clot. Now with the mechanisms we're using and the spins and the tubes we have, we don't have clotting. Because in aesthetics, you can't really put a gel, like a real thick coagulated gel in the face. We needed to figure out how to make a liquid first that maintained a liquid. So once we figured that part out, that allowed us to do it. So we can maintain a liquid for up to an hour. Whereas PRF, as the dentists use it, they often use the clotted plug. Great question. Smart crew.
Well, we have a lot of people. Someone wants you to come to Puerto Rico now, so it looks like...
I love Puerto Rico. There's a great wave spot. I want to say it's the northwest, and I was up in that bay there in Puerto Rico, and there was a reef. You had to navigate out through this narrow reef, and then you get to the outside, and the waves were nectar. I will come to Puerto Rico during wave season, and I also hear you don't have to pay tax down there, so maybe... I gotta get injected now. And I talk way better than I can get injected.
When you inject the gel under the eye superficial, do you stay under the rim or do you get close to the lash line?
So if you have a herniated fat pad, your orbital septum also herniates. And if you go through that, you're now in the orbital cavity. You guys, I'll close my eyes here, sorry. Just a little bit of alcohol. And it's safer to close your eyes.
Sorry. There you go.
And I use no anesthetic. I mean, when you get such a great injector like Jamie, why would I use anesthetic?
Are you ready for a pump?
You go do whatever you got to do. Okay, just make my under eye beautiful.
One, two, and
handsome. So we don't use it. I don't use anesthetic. You know, for one, I don't think it's needed. I guess you'll find out here in a second if I scream. But also, she's got to clean it. And I would say for me, if she hits some... So the first thing she's going to pop through... is the orbital retaining ligament.
Did you just feel that? Really good, Doc.
Wow. Orbital retaining ligament. Mine was just adulterated, perforated. and then she'll go medial, but she likely won't go through the tear trough ligament. From the inferior approach, she'll go
I'm going to get a little closer here.
The zygomatic cutaneous ligament, but that's below. And to me now, I feel it cool, because it was in the cooler, so that's a pretty cool feeling. So just to give you an idea, that would be what, the deeper layer there, Jamie, or what did you do first?
I did the deeper and then I kind of retro-injected and then I go back in on the superficial and then retro. If I hit a little bit of like difficulty, then I'll inject a little bit, kind of generate some space, and then kind of move through the tissue.
Did you teach me that or did I teach you that?
You taught me.
I love that you say that because I don't even have to talk anymore, Jamie. Oh, this is, can I take you with me everywhere?
Yeah. A couple more questions.
Sure could.
What size cannula, and also should you avoid caffeine before or after PRF?
We're using a 25 gauge 1.5 inch cannula. And then caffeine, I mean, Docs, you've been drinking it all day.
No, that's not true. I drink, like when I'm working on the road, I'm drinking it all day, right?
Two, three, and
little pinch. I didn't even know where you're going. I drink it all day when I'm on the road. When I'm at work, I drink one, it actually ends up being two cups in one big cup. I got a big Tim Hortons mug, so I guess there's two 8-ounce cups. But no, you don't have to worry about caffeine, I don't think. Jamie, do you see it? Maybe you see it?
No, I mean, we have busy people working all day in and out. So, you know, I kind of try to work with whatever works for them as long as it's something safe, you know?
I'm not in here. Yeah.
Can you readdress the use of herniated fat pad, please?
Readdress the use?
Use, yes.
The use of the fat pad?
Yes.
Where I was going with that is, when you said someone asked about the orbital rim, right? Mm-hmm. If you're on the orbital rim and the patient has a herniated fat pad, the orbital sept is very delicate. And if you, we were just, I just helped teach a course at LAMCA in March, and it's a cadaver course. Everyone should attend that next year. But you know, we looked at the cadavers, and we this is exactly what we did do. And so you could, you want to not use the orbital rim as a landmark because the orbital septum could be there. But if there's not a herniated fat pad, then yes, you can be right along that orbital rim. Now, what would happen if you went into the orbital septum? Often not a lot, but risk of infection, it's not good practice, there's many things. What are we doing now, Jamie? Because I can't narrate it, I can't fully tell.
Yeah, we were just doing the lateral orbital rim.
Oh, yeah, nice.
Yeah, oftentimes it's not just your tear trough, but it's the whole orbital rim that needs to be treated. So,
isn't that great? Mm-hmm.
Does PRF clot if you need to inject quickly?
No.
Okay.
Not with the system we're using. I used to not be able to say that. I used to have to say, yes, it does. We had 20 minutes.
Yeah.
But Jamie figured it all out. The scientist she is.
Huh? Cooling mechanisms has been great. Gives us a little bit more leeway, a little bit more time. Dang,
such great questions. How many mLs would you inject under the eyes?
I'll tell you my average, and then she'll tell you hers. Mm-hmm. Like a PRF liquid, 1.5 cc's per eye, which is one tube. A PRF gel, it really, I look... How much did you use on mine, Jamie?
I just used 2 mLs.
2 mLs? Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh, I was a bad case. I needed 2 mLs. Good, I'm stoked. No, so there you go. She put 2 mLs. Also, normally you will ask someone about downtime stuff. She can overfill me a bit and I'm fine because we know you can massage it over. We know that if I'm overfilled a little bit, I would caution people, in general for your patients, don't go crazy and overfill too much for the average patient because it does hold. Mm-hmm. Okay, so I'd rather have a little more because I don't care. You see the redness? I had my fractionated RF and my RF microneedling, so I'm already beat up. And I'm only going to do this every once a year, so I want a little more dose. But in general, with the plasma fill, with the easy gel, fill to fullness, maybe a tad more, Jamie?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I do a little tad more if they can take the downtime.
Yeah, but not, don't go crazy and double and triple it unless it's like she's doing me or whatever. Now where are we going?
We're
going
to go to your right.
Okay, okay.
And we're going to do the tear trough area over here.
Okay.
Just do a little bit of cleanser.
I'm glad I'm going to be symmetric. I'm doing both sides. It's good.
Dr. Chopra says, looking great, brother. Miss you. Tell us, how many ounces of water are you crushing per day?
Dr. Chopra, I wish that I could say that I drank water well. Do I, girls?
No.
They don't. I'm going to blame it on the staff here. This is a staff problem. Haley.
I'm only second woman.
She drinks water bottles like crazy. But no, I don't drink a lot of water, and I should. But I'll tell you, when I go home, when I drink,
I'll give you a little pinch.
This is my drink of choice. Here comes the opening. My drink of choice is soda water plus pomegranate, pure pomegranate juice.
Oh, that is your drink.
Yeah, yeah. I put a third, like whatever, you know, shot a couple shots of pomegranate and soda water. And that way you don't reach for a beer.
What's the max PRF not gel you could put under the eyes?
There's no real max, but I guess the max I've ever done is maybe 3 mLs an eye. Jamie, what do you...
I would say 3 because that's usually what I have in the syringe, and not many people can take that downtime.
Like, yeah.
That's the big thing for me that I assess.
Yeah.
On a deeper layer here, sorry.
How long does swelling stay after easy gel? A week? A couple days?
I say it definitely lasts a bit longer than the PRF liquid. So PRF liquid, I say about 3 to 5 days, depends. But the easy gel, I'd say about a week it can, depending on the volume that you place in there. Doing okay,
Doc? Perfect. Okay. I mean, I don't, honestly, if you want to know about pain, here's the thing. There's no heparin or sodium citrate. So when you're putting it in, I feel cool, which is fine. Who cares, right? It's like cool, feels good. But there's no burning or stinging at all because there's no sodium citrate or heparin, right?
No.
There's no blood thinner. The blood thinner is what hurts.
Turn you slightly to your left.
And I will say I'm probably a difficult patient because there would be some Sculptor permeated up there because I've had Sculptor in the high cheek before.
And I felt that on your left lateral kind of orbital rim area, so you can feel it sometimes.
Yep.
For someone who has creepy skin under the lash line, can you inject the gel superficially close to the lash lines?
Yes, and you can also take a Q-tip and massage it up. Mm-hmm. Here, I'll open one eye.
Yeah.
Then you massage it up. It's wonderful that way. And here's the thing. Mm-hmm. You can't put filler up there. Mm-hmm. In Asia, we do create that double bubble. Some people want it, right?
Yes.
But you don't see that in America. And in general, so you could put filler up there. That's, I guess I said it wrong. People here don't want volume up there to get rid of the wrinkle. What is it? It's collagen loss. Yeah. It's elastin loss. And so why hit that with a filler? And if you put Botox up there, you can get a blank stare and a dry eye. Mm-hmm. And remember, Botox is a Band-Aid, right? Dysport, neuromodulators, the new Doxify. They're not going to build collagen or help your fat pads.
Have you ever worried about overfilling with EasyGel?
I do. So you fill to maybe 10% overcorrection max. Like for an under eye, because people are sensitive to the under eye. If you're talking the anterior cheek, you have a little more leeway. The high cheek, of course, is beauty, youth, and fertility. So go to town on it.
A little pinched up, just so you know.
Yep. No, I would be a tough cannula case. And she will persevere with the cannula in the under eye. But if you had to in the cheek or somewhere, nasolabial fold, use a needle. Don't be freaked out. That's okay to do. Many great injectors use needles. But you have your angular artery right up near the nose here. So we do like to use a cannula under the eye. And don't forget, there's a zygomatic. Your zygomatic or your cheekbone is a foramen. Zygomatic foramen, which is a little vessel. And that vessel communicates with the retina, which is the back of the eye, which causes blindness. So we like to use a cannula for the under eye, and we'll persevere. But that's what separates great clinics from others, is take your time.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
For under eye and cheeks, what is the repeat time for EasyGel? How long does it stay?
So for me, I haven't had it in a year. I'm pretty happy. I'm still pretty happy, but why not? It's been a year. Do it. But for a lot of people, if they're empty now or they're just starting, they don't have healthy fat pads, they have crepey skin, you treat on day one, which would be like now, and then you treat them again at 6 weeks and then yearly.
Sorry, I know this is a little tough.
No, I don't even feel it.
Oh, perfect. Well, no. We just got through, so wonderful.
Yeah. So what happens is, see, she was pushing, and we, by nature, think that hurts, right? So, but I didn't feel much, so great. But also, you do.
And what size for the needles in the nasolabial fold?
If you want to use a needle, for 23 gauge, we have 2 inches.
Yeah.
Most of ours are 2 inches, right?
And depends. We have both a lot.
We have both. So there you go. I would say the one thing that I didn't even feel that one, honestly. Perfect. So I would say the one thing you don't want to put PR up on top of is a chemical peel, because you want that acidic pH.
Yeah.
But fractionated RF, whatever else you're using to resurface, great. CO2 laser, wonderful. So that's the under eye. And now I got a YouTube video to put up Sunday. I'm going to be, what's our topic? We need to pick a YouTube video for Sunday. Ooh. What do you guys want to see?
Yeah, that's a great question.
How bad Coca-Cola is for you?
Diet Coke.
Diet Coke.
Can you talk about the risk of vascular occlusion?
Yeah, so again, there's articles out there on PRP causing occlusion blindness, stuff like that. There's a couple cases with PRP. With PRF, there's zero cases that I'm aware of that are bona fide. Could it happen? 100%. Do I expect it'll happen in the industry? Of course. So take every precaution as if it can happen. The reality is, fillers cause spasm. It's not just inter-arterial issues that we're worried about. It's spasm of the vessel. Because you can clamp off vessels during surgery and have no problem. So HA fillers are special. So I think the risk is way less, but yes, it could occur. Always use good practices, use cannulas, slow injecting, know your anatomy, know your angular arteries here, know that zygomatic artery, all those things. But I think the risk, you're taking way more risk driving to the grocery store than you are getting injected.
Can you use PRF in the temples or EasyGel in the temple?
I would have normally said no, but now we have 3D imaging showing that it's okay. So like that it's holding. I would have thought, oh no, it's not going to be powerful enough. But there's enough fat up there that we're seeing it hold to 15 months.
Do you need to...
You want me to hold that?
Oh no, you're good.
Okay. Let's figure out where we're going. This is all about me. About
sorry.
What do you think? Where do you want to go?
Nasolabial fold next, probably.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do I need any deep medial fat pad or no? That's going to make me look fat.
Well, I kind of got it a little bit on the downturn here and through this area. I kind of hit it.
Ask them.
Both
ask you guys. Comment. What should? What do I need? Where are we going to do it? That you said that. They want me to do my lips in here.
I say you should do it.
Well, if you say, then you got to come see the camera. She doesn't like being on camera. She's the superstar of the whole show.
The model.
She's the supermodel sitting there, doesn't want to be on camera. But I'll do whatever you guys want me to.
And I can just show you guys the difference in the color and kind of the consistency. This is the albumin right here, and then this is the PRF. That's kind of how it looks. And then we mix it all together to get that nice fluid consistency.
So this is, you see, about 3 cc's and 1.5 roughly.
Mm-hmm,
so you get 4.5 cc's.
Yep.
This is all your goodness and your great cells. Mm-hmm. This is the albumin that's going to hold and create, the scaffolding. Mm-hmm.
People are definitely saying lips.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
I'm not lying. Right, Haley? Oh. Yeah.
We have an extra one PRF. I'll do whatever you want.
Lips and temples.
It's not going to give me a...
That's all you got.
That's all you got. Mm-hmm. Okay, well, do whatever you're doing, but... lips, my God, what am I going to do with lips?
They say lips and temples. It's going back and forth.
Temples? Okay, well, we can do nasal labial. I think you need a little in there.
Yeah.
You know, down in the chin. We always do the chin on just about everyone because especially females tend to get a little more bone loss, but I see I'm running higher estrogen or something's going on with
Tell them Dominique says temples.
Oh, okay. Dominique, oh no, of course. She has a great... console. How would I not do what Dominique says? Okay.
Yes, on the chin, corners of the mouth. I mean, maybe we just keep injecting you.
Well, I'm all up for that. Trying to look better and better. So let's do nasal labial because people want to see that because we're doing more and more. I would like some down here, but if instead you guys want to do lips, I'll do it for you. But I mean, I don't want big. I don't need.
No.
I don't feel like I want big lips, but I'll do a little bit.
I think downturn is quite accurate.
Downturn of the mouth. That's. Mm-hmm. They want me to look happy all the time.
Yes.
One question is Easy Gel or PRF better than Sculptra? Can you comment?
It's like saying, is one whole different treatment better than another? Here's what I will tell you. When you are mowing your lawn this spring, you're mowing your lawn, and you look over the fence, and your neighbor's over there, and you look over, and you say, hey, Martha, or hey, Jim, and you go... Come on in my spa, my medical clinic. I'm gonna do filler for you. They're gonna say filler. What the hell? I don't want that in my face. 95% of the world do not want fillers. So they want all natural. But if you say I'm gonna take a blood draw, I'm gonna rejuvenate your face, your skin, your fat pads are gonna make you look younger without anything synthetic. Mm-hmm. They'll be like, I'm coming in for that.
Yep.
So understand it's a whole nother segment of the market. Am I getting Sculptra today? No. Am I getting this? Yes. Mm-hmm. Will I get this all day long? Yes. Nothing against Sculptra, but if I can do all natural, I'm going to do it.
Mm-hmm.
And even if she said to me, you know what? You're a little far gone. You might need 2 sessions. I'm still going to do all natural.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm willing to spend a little more to get it.
Yeah.
So understand that's most of the world. But so you can't say one's better than another. We still use Sculptra, of course, mm-hmm. and I still inject fillers. And I did... 3 lips today, 3 lip fillers. I know people think I'm the non-lip filler guy, but I did 3 sets of lip fillers today. So even Rajani's injected lips.
I know, I think I did.
It looked great.
Did they? So my work looked great, Haley? Okay, good. See that? They did good, okay.
And so Haley might be able to answer this because I know you guys don't do pricing, but what is the price point per session?
I think it's a great question, and I think... you know, first of all, you're in a sense. You charge whatever the heck you want. You charge what you're worth for your time. I mean, no, there's no price limit up or down. But in general, you can go.
Yeah.
I guess I can't talk, can I?
No, you can talk. Can talk. I can work around.
I can talk a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Okay. 1, 2, and 3.
Right here, good. My period of being unable to talk is max 25 seconds. So, okay, I'll let you go with this.
No, you can talk. I can work around you, Dom. Just let me... You're good.
And so I say if you're doing 5 tubes of blood and you're doing, it just doesn't feel anything. Maybe you're not in there.
No, I'm in there.
Okay.
Yeah.
maybe I'm just so old, I got no nerve fibers left. I'd say $2,500 per session for 10 cc's. And you can do brow, you can do a little bit of hair, you're drawing blood anyway. Mm-hmm. She took 5 tubes from me. What's the difference if she took 3 or 5? My blood's fairly free. So, but you charge whatever you want. Under eyes, what would we be, $1,000? $1,000 for under eyes? Mm-hmm. And I think that's a fair price. People get great results, it's safe.
That's good.
Yeah, that looks great.
Use that.
I mean, I didn't feel anything. So whatever that means, I don't know. And there's no lidocaine in here. Just okay. So you know, like some fillers have lidocaine, there's no lidocaine in here.
Okay, little pinch. 1, 2, and 3, 4.
Pretty tough there, boss.
I mean, it's a little poke. Once a year, I can deal with this stuff. And I'm not like a big toxin fan. I mean, I rarely do Botox, Dysport, all that stuff. I'd rather do this.
How deep is Jamie going?
Right now? Like mm-hmm. the initial poke or the injection itself?
Injection.
So I like to go a little bit deeper on here, kind of near the bone, because mm-hmm. obviously the PRF and the Easy Gel help rejuvenate bone. And that's why dentists and orthopedic surgeons use it. So I go a little bit deep and then like retrograde, anterior grade, kind of work my way up so I hit all layers, but I make sure to hit that lower layer. And you'll see I'll kind of feel around where the cannula is. I can lift it to see where I'm at depth-wise and kind of get a feel for it. But doing it in the plane that's gonna actually treat is gonna be very helpful.
I think the nasal ala is undertreated. Mm-hmm. And now that Sculptor has FDA approval on the bone for the nasal ala, people are aware of it mm-hmm. in this clinic. Mm-hmm. Because shells lose bone. And so by bringing that whole piriform aperture forward, it creates a beauty angle.
Yes, it does.
Would you agree with that?
Mm-hmm.
Because we're not just wanting to rejuvenate the skin and the fat pads, but we want to take everything towards symmetry and towards beauty or handsomeness. I always want to look that word up. I never know what to call a guy. Is it a word, handsomeness? You got to ask the UK guys. The British speak the best English in the world. I trained in medical school in the British system, and I guess I'm failing the British system. I'm gonna ask the king now, because unfortunately we don't have the queen. God rest her soul. But we need the queen's English here. Ask the UK guys, handsomeness. What do you call a guy?
Handsome.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, what would be the adjective be?
Next question I have, what is your stance of the quality of Easy Gel based on a patient's age and health? I know you talked about this, but...
We don't pay attention to it. If the person's healthy and they can heal from a wound or a cut, their exosomes, their growth factors, their play, everything works.
Looks great, doctor. What are you going to do next, Jamie?
Who said that? I got to send them a free skincare. Whoever's complimenting me, we are going to reward that.
Don't say that, because you have a lot of people who are upset you're not shipping your skincare internationally yet.
We hit a block today again. I'm spending a lot of money trying to go internationally, and today I had bad news on that. But don't get me started.
So handsomeness is correct, by the way.
Oh, wow, Doc got something right today. I got 3 good lip fillers and the word handsomeness.
You're winning, and it's Friday.
And it's Friday.
Yes.
Can I have a... whiskey tonight?
Let's keep focused. What are we doing next now?
Okay,
so we're going to do the downturn of the mouth right here. Everyone kind of gets that lag and that indentation, kind of that pre-jaw area when the bone starts to deteriorate, kind of slides down right there. So we're just going to come in laterally, give them a little bit of a bridge to kind of kick up the edge of the lip. So you look happy every day, Doc.
Not that
you don't.
No, well, you know this, the latest studies on the feedback for dermal fillers and toxins show that feedback mechanism helps depression.
It does.
Helps you become more successful. When you're walking down the road, mm-hmm. and this is just part of these weird things, like, and you look good, and you look at cool things.
Yeah, a dream.
I got on a nice private jet and went skiing.
There you go.
My mouth was up
and someone's going to give you maple whiskey, and we know who.
Oh, my maple whiskey connection.
There you go.
I'll shut up now.
Concerns with results with patients in autoimmune.
This is the juice for autoimmune
because
it's their own stuff. She's added nothing back except my own proteins, my own growth factors, stem cells.
Mm-hmm. Coming in close.
I'll stop here.
Might do another little pinch here.
I got 3.
What about hollowed eyelids? Can you say something about that?
Yeah, we do that a lot in Asia. I don't do that a lot in this country. personally, on a personal note, I never find it. I'll stop for a minute here.
Yeah, sorry. There you go.
Mm-hmm. I never find it like earth-shattering, changing difference with fillers. Or I think the majority of people that come in need what I got done first. Under eye, chin, deep medial fat pad up here. If you're going to that level, sure, it can be done. I have no experience with easy gel up there. I do have a lot of experience with fillers up there. Your risk of blindness if you go deeper along the bone where the supra orbital vessels come increases your risk. So you just have to be careful. But I mean, some people do it and like it. Mm-hmm. But with easy gel, I don't have experience.
For dark circles, which is better, easy gel or PRF plane?
You need both, typically. Mm-hmm. But if there's no hollow, you can just use the liquid. If there's a hollow like I had today, then you're going to need probably both. Why not both? The answer to normally is both.
Yeah.
You know?
It's more common than not also.
Yeah.
That looks nice. That pushed it up a little bit.
Keep pushing it up. We like the word up, right? As we age, everything's going down. We'll take up. But to be fair, I really think we're affecting the fat pads. And why does that pull down? Well, it's not just that the muscle got stronger, okay? It's that the fat pad is not supporting the muscle. So the muscle's hanging there, and by nature, it's going to contract. When we support this, now you could support it with filler. Mm-hmm. And I'm not anything against filler, but filler's going to widen me. As a male, I could take that. That's okay. Mm-hmm. Females don't want to be widened. Okay, so, and I'd rather not be wide, and I think I'm happy with my shape. But for a man, you can add a little more filler and get away with it.
Little pinch right here. 1, 2, 3, and pinch. Good.
And so this you're doing with a cannula tube. Mm-hmm. Okay, so you see we've done everything so far today with a cannula, mm-hmm. right?
Yep.
Now, I take krill oil, Jamie. Am I bleeding from the krill oil?
Not too bad.
Okay, mm-hmm. Well, I got to double my dose. I don't want to take a stroke. I take that krill oil to thin the blood, you know?
Yeah.
You guys all should be on krill oil, turmeric, K2, D3, collagen powder, and coming soon, plasma restore vitamin.
Excited for that.
Yeah, bamboo extract, vitamin A orally, vitamin C and vitamin E, and then a bunch of fruit extracts. So everyone on our PRF will get that.
How long do results last? What should we tell our patients?
About a year. That I mean, we have, if you go to plasmafil.com, look at those pictures, those are out 15 months with no addition. And the 3D imaging, you can see volume, you can see increased vectoring and lifting. And I gotta say, I'm surprised. I would not mm-hmm. have expected. When they walked in, Haley, over there, you can talk over there. Those patients walked in for their follow-up in 15 months. We were all shocked. We're like, oh my gosh, what else did you do in the meantime? Mm-hmm. Right?
Yeah.
They looked gorgeous. And I was like, wow. So it took us by surprise is as much, wouldn't you say, Jamie?
I would say.
It took you by surprise.
Yeah, when you look at the 3Ds too, you see how it affects them dimensionally, which is really important versus the 2D photos. Like, it's a big difference.
And the vectoring, and let me give you an example. Like, we didn't do anything through here with them, and you could see the hollowing that mm-hmm. they created over the 15-month period. And where we added, you could see the volume increase and maintained. Yeah. But just looking at them in real life, mm-hmm. they just look good.
Yeah.
I was like, wow. So we're surprised. Honestly, I'm surprised by the results. And for instance, the person I had yesterday, I did PRF. 2.5 months ago we did it, and his under eye looks almost perfect.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
One session of PRF liquid that was. Mm-hmm. So, I don't know.
Okay, so we want to break down on the CCs used today.
Great.
Okay. So we did 2 mL on that left, like lateral orbital rim and the tear trough area. On the right side here, I did 1.5 because this one wasn't as deep on this lateral orbital rim. I did 1.5 in each nasal labial fold, and then just 0.5 on the downturn in the mouth.
Okay, and he looks has some volume there under that is injected under the eye. How long is the downtime in the swelling?
I would say swelling downtime probably about 7 to 10 days with the easy gel, kind of extends for a little bit longer. If you use the PRF liquid, I suggest about 3 to 4 days, but most people like the swelling at the end of each of those cycles. So usually day for the liquid, day 4 is like their favorite. They're still swollen, but it looks like perfect. And then for the easy gel, probably day 7 or 10, depending on how they are healing.
And like with Sculpture, you massage. Is there any work that needs to be done by the patient after they're injected?
No, if I do any massaging, I'll do it post-injection, like right away, so it's easier to manipulate. But I like to leave it where I place it because that's the area that we want to treat specifically.
If you really want to move it too, grab a Q-tip and roll it, like for the under eye, or you can just, it's very malleable, huh?
Totally, yeah.
And remember, you're flooding. It's, what makes it easier than doing filler is if you see a little irregularity, a high spot, low spot, you don't care. Because what you're doing is growth factors, stem cells, exosomes, and you're taking your own stuff and making it healthy. It's not like you've added a foreign body that's going to leave a nodule, lump, or bump.
Correct.
So it's easier.
So you don't have to be so precise as filler? That's okay.
Yeah.
And a lot more leeway. Any questions before we kind of sign off or anything you guys want to see? Friday night, I mean.
Thanks for letting me poke you, Doc.
Oh, I mean, honestly, it's not painful at all. And I don't know, there's usually not a lot of bruising with it, but I find with this type of a procedure, people accept the downtime because it's all natural.
Yes.
They don't go home and go, oh my God, what did I just do? This cheek's too high.
Yes.
This is asymmetric.
Correct.
Is it occluded? Is it this? Is it, oh, people won't recognize me. Mm-hmm. You can even tell your best friend who hates aesthetics, oh, I had a blood draw and they put my stuff back in me and they won't shame you for it because that still occurs. You know, people, we see that, like, or people don't want to tell their significant others or whoever.
Yeah.
There's still a stigma for some people.
There is,
So they're going to have to get me a, I'll cover up so no one sees what I've done on the way in. If I was a big celebrity, I'd say, oh, I just was gardening and I had a fruit juice. I took a little olive oil, maybe rode a horse or two, and now look at me.
There you go.
If you have filler under the eye, would you dissolve it first before doing like an easy gel and PR?
If it looks bad, dissolve it. If not, you can go right on top. We go right on top regularly because typically it looks good, you know, but if they're having problems with it, dissolve it. And I would wait probably 4 to 7 days when I typically wait before I dissolve it and then bring them back in 4 to 7 days.
Yeah, because sometimes people need 2 sessions of dissolver sometimes. It just depends how much has been placed, the time, the depth, all those things are important. So medical history is really important also for us to know.
And filler lasts 8, 10, 12 years. We have people come in here from, oh, I haven't had filler. And you take a history, they go, well, 12 years ago, I did have something. Well, that's your filler.
Yeah.
So it lasts way longer than you think.
How long after, like, Athera or Morpheus 8 or RF microneedling, can you do this?
Same day. I had my RF microneedling yesterday, lower face, fractionated RF full face yesterday, and then do this today. Of course, you could do it the same day if we had to have the ability.
People love you, Jamie. They want to come in and see you.
Well, I love you guys.
You're going to be too busy now. I'm not going to be able to get an appointment.
You have VIP status.
They saw how little pain this was.
I know.
Like when people see that, right? But I'll tell you, I guess in closing is the most important thing her and I do, other than safety, is the facial consult.
Yeah.
And this is where people are getting steered wrong, why they're turning against aesthetics. Both of us would turn away about 20% of the people that come in a given day. We're like, you don't need it.
Yeah.
It's not appropriate for you. Or think about it and go home. Like the money is the very last thing. Money comes when you do the right thing. That's just how it works. And if you have something that works, people come back.
They do.
And I would say our PRF, or the growth of PRF in the practice is like this. It's not because we're telling people to do it or pushing it.
No.
They're coming in asking for it.
A lot of people want to know, because they're coming in and they're learning this, where can they get further training?
The best question in the world. For one, there's a free course, aesthetictrainingcenter.com. So that's your first. And I should update that in the next month or two, just a little bit. But aesthetictrainingcenter.com, everything we did and Jamie did today, it's all there for free. Watch it and rewatch it. And then, you know, reach out to us on that site and we'll try and hook you up. We are going to do some more training sessions with, say, 25. I also have a locator coming at store.rajanimd.com that's going to show who has their skincare. And those outlets that have the skincare, a lot of times they're doing PRF and the stuff we do. So you'll be able to say, well, they have Rajani skincare, likely they had training. And so as we train people, they'll be on that locator more prominently, and that's worldwide.
One last question, jawline. Can you use easy gel?
Yes, you can use it. Yeah. But if you want the sharpest jawline, you got to create that, probably calcium hydroxyl appetite. Radius is the highest G prime we have. So if you have someone that wants an instant boom, I use a lot of define in the jawline.
Yep.
So I use a lot of wrestling define in the jawline. People that have patients that want all natural, use it. I would say better than that would be those smile lines.
Correct.
So you can use filler in the jawline because you want to add a little bit of volume. Mm-hmm. Rejuvenating the fat that's already there.
Correct.
So yes, you can.
Okay, perfect.
Thank you on this Friday. Go have fun. Life is short. Go have fun. Enjoy. Jamie, thank you for that treatment.
Teamwork.
No downtime. I'll see you on the YouTube Sunday.
Bye.